So let's talk about headers. Headers are quite easily the most important aspect of computer networking because they contain the information that allows for data to be sent correctly through the different hardware and logical devices on a network. For data to be packaged up and sent over a network from a sending device to the intended receiving device, you have to have headers containing the information about the data being sent, where it goes, what type it is, and which device sent it. To summarize the previous videos in this lesson just a little bit, when data or information is packaged up by the protocol stack on a sending device and sent down through that device's protocol stack out its NIC, or network interface card, onto the network cable, it is placed into a layer 3 packet first with headers at the beginning of the data and a CRC on the end, cyclic redundancy check. Now, those packet headers are usually either TCP or UDP, which we'll get into in a later lesson in this course. That packet with the header, the actual data, and the CRC trailer is then packaged into a layer 2 frame for sending to the next physical device on the network, a switch, a router, a hub, hopefully not. We don't want to be using hubs anymore, but a printer, a server, whatever that next device is. The layer 2 frame, which is wrapped around that layer 3 packet, also has a header of sorts containing destination and source MAC addresses, the frame type, etc. Now, when we refer to headers in the networking world, 95 to 99% of the time, we're talking about layer 3 packet headers. But for all intents and purposes, a frame has its own header information as well. So just understand that. But 95 to 99% of the time, they're talking about, when they just say the header, they're talking about the actual packet header. Without a header, your data won't make it to where it's supposed to go. Plain and simple. A header can contain the following information: the version of IP, whether it's IP version 4 or IP version 6, the sender's IP address, the receiver's IP address, or the one that it's being sent to, the number of packets in the message, the protocol being used, the time to live, the length of the packet, if this applies, and synchronization data. As we get more in-depth into computer networking, and actually don't let that in-depth scare you, because once you understand the principles I've laid out for you in this course, you'll be at a point where you understand most of the major concepts of networking, and you could probably pass the Network Plus exam with just a minor extra bit of study beyond this point anyway. So as we get more in-depth into computer networking, we'll examine those headers, packets, and frames a lot more closely so that you understand everything they contain and you know just about everything those headers actually do and how they're used by all of the components on a network. But for now, that is a basic, solid description of headers, packets, and frames to give you a running start in your understanding and your knowledge here.